Hi, I'm Professor Melko, chemistry PhD, and your university chemistry professor. Today we're going to talk about writing and balancing chemical reactions. This is really the heart of chemistry, and everything you do in chemistry moving forward rests on your ability to be able to write down a chemical reaction and balance it. So let's jump into the lecture. Writing chemical equations. So let's start with sort of identifying what reactants and products are, and the overall look of a chemical reaction. Okay, sometimes called a chemical equation like it is here. These describe chemical reactions using their chemical formulas that we've learned about in previous videos, and these symbols. Okay, so this denotes a molecule of hydrogen in the gas phase, reacting with, the plus sign, a molecule of oxygen in the gas phase. This arrow means it's making or producing. The molecule on the right, in this case, water. Okay, so on the left we have what's called the reactants. This coefficient in front means there's two of them. So here's a molecule of H2. But that coefficient in front means there's two of them, and these are supposed to be drawn identically. You can see how poor an artist your professor is. These two molecules of hydrogen then react with, so bump into, rearrange with, this molecule of oxygen, two oxygen atoms in the gas phase, and together these form two molecules of water. So here's this Mickey Mouse looking molecule of water, but there's two of them. So that's what we mean when we write down these chemical reactions with their formulas and symbols, right? We want to have this picture in our heads of these two molecules of hydrogen bumping into this one molecule of oxygen and then rearranging and producing these products on the right, two water molecules. Okay. Notice also we have these physical states, as I pointed out here, the gas phase on the left, the liquid phase on the right. Those are denoted in parentheses, solid, liquid, gas, aqueous. And the coefficients out front tell us how many of each molecule are reacting or are produced. And importantly, as we'll see today, those coefficients are what we use to balance the chemical reaction. We never change these subscripts, right? Just the coefficients. So let's talk a little bit about that. Coefficients tell you how many of each molecule there is, right? In the previous example, it told us there were two molecules of hydrogen, right? You'll also notice in the reaction there was no number before oxygen. The one is almost never written in chemistry, it's always implied. Okay, so that sort of implies there's only one molecule of oxygen. The subscripts are down here below and to the right of the atomic symbol. Okay, so here the two and H2, this subscript, tells me how many of the atoms are in one molecule, right? So that's now how I know to draw this molecule of hydrogen as two different hydrogen atoms bound together. That's the point of a subscript. That tells you the number of atoms of this element, two hydrogens, within this given molecule, right? And similarly in H2O, I know there's two hydrogens, and again, the one is implied here. I don't write it. The subscript on oxygen is a one. There's one oxygen, two hydrogens in one molecule of water. As we go through and balance reactions, we're never going to change these subscript numbers. We only balance chemical reactions by changing those coefficients in front of the molecules. Some other symbols, we've already touched on some of these, right? These are the state or phase of matter. In that previous example, we had hydrogen and oxygen gases, so we used parentheses, lowercase g, and it was making water, parentheses, lowercase l, for liquid. Sometimes you'll see this NR for no reaction. We'll see that in later examples. The plus here is reacts with, right, or is heated with, something that denotes molecule A is reacting with molecule B. That's the plus sign, right? So in our example here, this plus sort of separates the two reactants from one another, tells you they're reacting together. the arrow is produces or gives, right? So at H2, the state is gas, reacts with, is how I would read this, one molecule of oxygen, gas phase, to produce, arrow, two molecules of H2O in the liquid phase. Okay, so that's connecting now this language to those symbols that we use when writing these reactions down. Now, one thing to point out here is that seven elements in the periodic table occur as diatomics, right? Where di means two, and atomics means atoms, okay? So a lot of times in the chemical language, you'll see hydrogen gas, and you just have to know that means H2, right? Two atoms of hydrogen, because it's a diatomic. There's seven of these, it turns out, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, and iodine. So that as you read the text of a question and it says iodine gas, you need to know that's I2, not just I1. Okay, same goes for hydrogen and oxygen. That's how I knew, if I was reading hydrogen gas reacts with oxygen gas, to have these subscripts 2. Okay, that doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be 2 out in front. That comes from balancing the chemical reaction. Okay, so commit these to memory: hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. Most of them live over here in this sort of corner of the periodic table. Hydrogen is the exception, as it is with a lot of things in chemistry. Now, the most important part of this lecture, how to balance chemical reactions. Okay. First and foremost, your formulas need to be correct, right? If it's oxygen gas, it's O2. If you write it as just O1, you're never going to come up with the right reaction. So it's really imperative that you understand how to name chemical compounds and what chemical formulas those compounds are related to. Second, after we have the formulas down and sort of orient reactants and products and separate them with an arrow, we balance each element by using whole number coefficients. Okay, so we'll see this in some examples, but the coefficients out front, don't use fractions, don't use 1.75, don't use 3/2, just use whole numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. And never, never, never change those subscripts. Begin with the most complex species, so if there's this big ugly looking molecule with a bunch of different atoms, right, start with that molecule, count up the atoms, and start, you know, use that as your starting point of where to balance this reaction. Sometimes the elements are all, or the molecules are all pretty simple, so it doesn't matter where you start. But if there is this large, complicated molecule, maybe with polyatomics, perhaps start there. With regard to polyatomics, you can balance those as a single unit. Most of the elements in the chemical reaction, you're going to treat singularly, like hydrogen, count up all the hydrogens and balance that. Chlorine, count up all the chlorines and balance that. But if you have these polyatomics, right, like NO3 as part of maybe potassium nitrate, you can treat this whole unit, this whole polyatomic, as one NO3 unit when you go through and balance it. Because if it's on the left, it's probably going to appear in that same polyatomic way on the right. So there's an NO3 on the left, there needs to be an NO3 on the right. So that's what I mean here. After we balance, confirm each element is balanced, so go back and count up left and right and make sure those numbers are equal, and then verify the lowest whole number ratio is used. Okay, this means I don't want to have 4H2 plus 2O2 goes to 4H2O. All those coefficients here can be divided by 2. Right, so here I would rewrite this 2H2 plus 1O2 goes to 2H2O. Right, you want that simplest whole number ratio. All right, so let's get some practice with this. You could be given a question like this where you're just told in written out form what's reacting with what and what is produced. Okay, so use the keywords here: hydrogen gas, that's a molecule, and chlorine gas, separate molecule. React, this means plus, to produce means arrow, and these words that I'll box here tell us the phases or state of matter of each. Another thing to pay attention to, again, is these diatomics, hydrogen gas. Let's start thinking about this. That's one of the diatomics. So as soon as I see hydrogen gas, I can write down H2. I know it's a diatomic in the gas phase. It reacts with chlorine gas. So I separate it by a plus sign. Chlorine, the symbol is Cl. It is also one of the special diatomics. So that looks like this. To produce, I draw my arrow to separate my reactants on the left from products on the right. What is it producing? Gaseous hydrochloric acid. Okay, so in previous lectures, we talked about naming acids. This one, it turns out, hydrochloric acid is HCl. Okay, and you might be able to figure that out from the periodic table. H is in this plus one group, chlorine is in this minus one group, so hydrochloric acid in a 1-to-1 ratio, probably just HCl, right? But I would just memorize these acid formulas. Great, check the formulas are correct. H2, that looks right, that's a diatomic. Chlorine 2, that's a diatomic. HCl, I know that's the formula for hydrochloric acid, but I forgot the phase, so I'll add in that gas. All right, formulas and states of matter are correct. Usually these acids actually are aqueous, but since it specifies gaseous, I know to write this G here next to HCl. Balance each element by using whole number coefficients. Okay, so first, the way I like to do this is sort of separate, and just draw a line here, the reactants from products. Okay, and I'm going to write and keep track of hydrogens and my chlorines here on the left and the right. Okay, on the left there's two hydrogens. Because of that subscript tells me there's two atoms of hydrogen in this one molecule, right? So I'm balancing per element, not per molecule. Okay, there's two hydrogen atoms, so I denote two H's to keep track of. Same with chlorine, there's two on the right, there's only one of each. Why? Because there's one molecule of HCl. There's no subscripts written, so they're implied to be one. Okay, so now I can balance the elements. Two hydrogens on the left, I need two hydrogens on the right. I can do that not by adding a subscript, okay? Never change the subscript here. I need to change this one to a two by putting a two out front, right? So the coefficient two here now has changed this to two hydrogen molecules on the right, and now that is balanced with the left. Whenever you add a coefficient, though, make sure you're updating each of the elements it's affecting. I updated hydrogen, now let's update chlorine. The two in front now means I also have two chlorines on the right, which is convenient because that's what I need on the left. So now left and right is balanced with respect to hydrogen and chlorine. Okay, so this one's pretty straightforward. I just wanted to show an easy example before we sort of built up to harder. We haven't changed subscripts. Begin with the most complex. This one's pretty straightforward. There are no polyatomic ions. We used whole number coefficients, no fractions here. Confirm each element is balanced. Yes, two hydrogens, two chlorines, two chlorines. Verify the lowest whole number ratio is used. Okay, one coefficient for hydrogen, one coefficient for chlorine, two coefficient for HCl. These numbers can't get any smaller. Here's a practice problem. If you want, pause the video now and try this one yourself. Then I'll work through it. Okay. Aluminum metal is heated with oxygen gas to give. So that sort of points to an arrow in the chemical reaction separating reactants from products. Solid aluminum oxide. Write the balanced chemical equation for this reaction. Okay, a few things. Let's first write down all the reactants. Okay, so before this to give, the reactants are aluminum metal and oxygen gas. Okay, aluminum here on the periodic table, not one of the diatomics. So I know this is just going to be aluminum. And it's a metal at room temperature that is a solid. Great, so here's one of my reactants. Aluminum solid. It reacts with oxygen gas. Oxygen is one of these diatomics, so I know this is O2 gas. Okay, now I have my two reactants. Let me think about my product, aluminum oxide. Here I have to do a little bit of thinking. Aluminum is plus 3, oxygen minus 2. So I use the crossover rule here. To come up with the formula. Okay. So this gives solid aluminum oxide, Al2O3. You have to spend some time getting comfortable with writing these formulas. Go back, watch previous videos. Do some practice problems, because if you can't get the formula right, you're not going to balance the reaction correctly. Okay, so here's my chemical reaction. Now I can start balancing it. On the left, one aluminum, two oxygens. On the right, two aluminums, three oxygens. Okay, I'm going to start with balancing the oxygens. It's a little bit more complicated. Aluminum is just itself. Oxygen's a diatomic. Let's start with balancing the oxygen. Two on the left, three on the right. How do I get these numbers to be the same? I can't use 3/2 or anything to balance. So I can think of, what is the common multiple here? 6. So if I can get both of these to 6, that'll balance out. And I can do that by adding a 3 on the left here and a 2 on the right. Each molecule of aluminum oxide has 3 oxygens. So if I add a 2 coefficient in front, this oxygen becomes 6 on the right. Now, be careful here, this coefficient has also updated the aluminum. So I need to change that before I go any further. Okay, so this coefficient of 2 in front, now I have 4 aluminums on the right, 6 oxygens on the right. The 6 oxygens are now balanced. But now this aluminum on the left, there's only 1. I need it to be 4. So I add a 4 coefficient in front. And now this balances the reaction. 4 aluminum solids plus 3 molecular oxygens in the gas phase react to make 2 molecules of solid aluminum oxide. Okay, so that's a slightly more complicated balancing chemical equation. Make sure you're practicing lots of these. Do some with polyatomics. We'll get some practice more in future videos as well. That'll do it for today's lecture. Next up, we'll learn how to classify reactions and work to balance more chemical reactions. As always, if you like this video, feel free to subscribe to my channel on YouTube. And every week I do office hours on Twitch, usually Tuesdays and Wednesdays. So you can check out my video to learn how to sign up on Twitch and meet me over there where we do practice problems, answer all your chemistry questions, and talk about the latest in science news. That'll do it for today's lecture. See you next time.